Hello everyone, you welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to fix the OBS NDI plugin problem. Now this is a problem that a lot of people face, especially when you upgrade the OBS software from 27 to 28 or 29, you discover that the NDI plugin is no longer functioning. And in today's video, I'm going to show you the steps and how I was able to fix this problem so you too can also fix it on your OBS software. Now if you look right here at the top left on the screen, you see that I'm using the latest version of OBS, and then when I click on the add button on sources, you see that the NDI source here is also showing and is working perfectly fine, because I've also tested it with Bible Show and lots of other softwares that enables NDI. I also tested it out with them and it worked perfectly fine, and I'm going to show you how you can be able to fix this problem and continue to run your OBS software in peace. Okay, now if you're just coming across this channel for the first time or you haven't subscribed, please smash that red subscribe button below and also turn on the notification bell so YouTube will notify you first whenever I upload videos like this on this channel. And if you're a returning subscriber, kudos to you. Thank you very much for being part of the family. Remember to also share the video so a lot of people can also benefit from the wealth of knowledge we're sharing on this channel. And without any further ado, let's jump right in to the tutorial. Now the first thing that you're going to do is to go ahead and open this link right here. I'm also going to drop it in the description below, so once you click on that, you'll be able to get straight to this web page you're seeing right here on the screen. Now once you get here, you see the OBS NDI 4.11.1. now the problem why the OBS NDI plugin wasn't functioning when you upgrade from the 27 to 28 is because you also need to upgrade that OBS NDI plugin. If you look right here on the screen, see the requirement, you see it, the 4.11.1 requires OBS 28 or 29 for it to be able to work, meaning if you're using an older version of OBS, or and once you've upgraded to the OBS 28 without upgrading the plugin, it will stop working. All right, now here is it right here on the screen. Just get straight to this web page, scroll down all the way down, and the first thing you are going to do if you're using Mac is to download the NDI runtime. Okay, so if you're using Windows, download the second one here. If you're using Mac, download this first one here. I've also tested this on Mac and it worked perfectly fine. Okay, so download the one for the Windows. If you're using Windows here, I'm just going to click on that, and you see it's downloading right here on the screen. And once you are done, also scroll down, because we need to find, scroll down and make sure you download this plugin right here. So the first one we downloaded is the runtime, and we also need to download the plugin itself. All right, now this is it right here on the screen. So if you're using Mac, you can download, you see the OBS NDI 4.11.1 for Mac and also for Windows as well, you see here. So the one you're going to download is the OBS NDI 4.11.1 Windows x64. That is the one you're going to download. Okay, so that's it here. That's it here. When you count from bottom, 1, 2, 3, the fourth one, when you count from bottom, that is the one you are going to download. I'm just going to download that. And once you've downloaded these two plugins right here on the screen, the next thing you are going to do is to go ahead and install it. Now, mind you, don't install this plugin if you've not upgraded your OBS to 28 or 29. Okay, so if you are still using the OBS 27, keep on using it. The older version of the plugin will work for you, but once you've upgraded your OBS to 28 or 29, that is when you need to download and run this. Now the first thing you are going to do is to run the NDI 5.3 runtime. Okay, so just right click on it, and you see the run as administrator right here on the screen. Select the run as administrator and install it. Let me also show you the steps. I accept here, next, and then because it's already existed, next again, and click the install button, and that will install the NDI 5 runtime on your PC. Now once you've done installing the NDI 5 runtime, the next thing you're also going to do is to install the plugin itself. Okay, now right click again, run as administrator. Remember to always run them as administrator. Run as administrator, and then next, and this is the install button right here on the screen. Once you click that, you'll be able to install the NDI plugin. Now once you've successfully installed these two plugins, the next thing you're going to do is to restart your PC. Okay, now if you don't restart your PC, it will not show, and make sure the OBS is closed while you are installing these plugins. All right, now make sure the OBS is closed while you're installing this plugin, and once you are done installing the plugin, restart your PC, and voila, you're going to see the NDI source right here on the screen. And let me also test it again for you to see that it's actually working. Okay, it's actually working. I'm going to pop up Bible Show software right now on the screen, and let's test this with it together to show you that it's working perfectly fine. Then pop up Ecclesiastic here 11, and then this one here, Okay, I already made series of videos on Bible Show. You can also check those out on the VMIS playlist. Click on the add button here on the sources, see the NDI source here, select that. Okay, and let's pop, you see, Paul PC Bible Show NDI, pop that on the screen, and you see the Bible is showing here. So let's select that, transform. Okay, and let's go over to transform here and fit to screen, and this is it here. You see the Bible is working perfectly fine, the NDI source is working, and this is how to fix the OBS NDI problem. Okay, especially when you upgrade your OBS from 27 to 28 or 29. If you're using the OBS 28, you can still run the plugin, it will work fine for you. If you're using the OBS 29, you can still also run it, it will work fine for you. Okay, so because the basic requirement is just you need to have the OBS 28 running on your PC before you can be able to run it, and it's working perfectly fine. So if you love the video or find it helpful, consider subscribing and also sharing the video, and don't forget to like it as well, so the YouTube algorithm can also, you know, spread out the content to more people, so they can also be part of our little family here we are building. Thank you very much, and see you in our next video.